Drew and T's destination is Drenner House. Built in 1835, it's one of the world's finest examples of a Georgian country estate. In a parkland setting and with immaculate Georgian interiors, it today earns its keep with weddings and events. But it's still the home of June Welsh. Chris runs the business with help from Kathy.
Drenner means a thorny place, and it was named Drenner when it was built.
Because we're using the house now as a business, we've had to declutter the house, so Mrs. Welsh has taken a lot of things out, and some things are for sale.
Well, the things in the stables have been there for a long time, and I'm afraid they've been just left and not very well looked after. There's a lot of mixed stuff, which I think we've got to poke around underneath and find it. I mean, it's not all obvious, and probably that's what Drew enjoys anyway.
Hello there.
Hello, Drew. Welcome to Drenner. Lovely to have you.
Thanks for having us.
Nice to see you.
Welcome
too.
To Drenner, Terry.
Thank you very much for having us.
You're very welcome.
What a beautiful entranceway. Oh, can't wait to see inside. Oh, beautiful. So who designed the house?
Charles Lanyon.
Okay.
And it was built in 1835.
So this is a Georgian era house, and it was finished just on the right at the end of the period.
Yes, luckily, just before the Victorians took over.
Lovely. Well, I'd love to see some more of the house.
The house is beautiful. It's just absolutely up my alley. The proportions, the colour of the stone, the size of the windows, the glass, the wonderful light in the entranceways, it's just the best.
Another beautiful room.
Yes, this is the dining room.
The house is wonderful, and the furniture in it's pretty damn good. Do you know what I'm really interested in? These.
Oh, they were to prop up the old boys when they had too much port.
Yeah, drunkards.
You used to stick it under their arms so it didn't fall over.
Do we need a couple of them, Drew?
We need these. Yeah, we need one each strap into us, to be honest with you, most of the time.
No, lovely.
The house has been in the same family since it was built, and the formal rooms are full of original furniture. But these are family heirlooms June wishes to retain. Where Drew can start buying is in the storage rooms.
Oh, a bed in the way.
Don't worry. A cute little table. This is absolutely untouched, the library.
Yes, sweet, isn't it?
It's very sweet.
This delicate mahogany side table was made to go against a wall in a hallway or reception room, and was probably used for a lamp or displaying ornaments. It's early 1800s and could be worth around £700.
Well, I'm sure we could do a deal on that.
I'll go all guns blazing out. The maximum I can pay for it is £400. I can't pay any more for it. I think I'm going to make £100.
OK.
Sure? Mm-hmm. OK, deal. Thank you. I want to do right by June, but also want to get the ball rolling. So I'm going to pay probably too much for it. There's a profit left in it, but not much. So we're going to give her £400 for it.
It's the first purchase and a lovely item, but there's not much profit in it. To make such a big trip worthwhile, Drew must find more things to buy. And he's got his hopes pinned on the stable block.
This is generally where the sort of detritus and bits of furniture that aren't being used gets thrown. The house this size, stables this big, I'm holding out for what I wanted when I was over here, which was, I want Irish furniture. Right. Well, it's not very hard for me to see something I like the look of already.
Yes?
These.
Oh.
Yeah. Particularly that one. I'm hoping they're shelved into the interiors.
Oh, that's quite useful.
Are you a keen gardener?
Yes, well, that's lovely.
That would have been for hot water. Taking hot water around the house.
Jolly useful. I'm buying that.
Do you want to make me an offer? Right, T, watch. There's something on the top
it's
there.
It's missing its that drawers, that's the only thing. The bottom.
It is. Nothing worse than missing your drawers.
It doesn't look in great condition, I have to say.
No, it's in terrible condition, but it's original. I'm hoping this one's shelved.
Yes. Oh, it's very sweet, I have to say.
These cupboards date back to the early and late 1800s. A house this size would have had many like these to store the household's bedding and linen. As well as being of interest to furniture collectors, they're also useful to restaurants and bars. With new drawers, the later cupboard could fetch around £750. The older cupboard, completely restored, could fetch around £1,500.
Done. I was going to say that this one could be what the Irish call a luck penny.
A luck penny?
Yes, they always throw it in.
I valued that one at hardly anything.
Well,
really,
that's your luck penny.
Thank you very much.
The majority of the price is for one cupboard. The other one comes along to hold its hand.
And you've got to strip all this horrible stuff off it.
No, that's why I bought it.
Oh, you're going to leave it?
Yeah.
Oh, do you like it?
I love it. That's original paint.
Oh, I see.
That's original paint over the pine carcass there, which you can see in there.
Oh, right.
That's what gives it the value. If this was in pine and all polished to death...
It would look awful.
It would look awful and I wouldn't want to even go near it.
Well, I'm delighted you've got it.
Wonderful. Please, please, sponge, it's been worth the trip.
And all I got was a little tin can.
With all the estate's furniture dumping grounds now explored, Drew gets one last look at the main house.
The library.
Library.
Oh, it's lovely, isn't it?
Yes, lovely, lovely
room. Gorgeous. Mm. There's a few things in here that I like the look of. That chair.
Yes, the pink chair. It's good, look at it.
Would this be something you'd be willing to get rid of?
Yes, I think so.
Yeah?
Depends what you offer for it.
Well, it's a nice one, but they usually go in the seat because they're very diminutive and, yeah, it's...
Sadly.
Yeah. Well, it's got a fair bit of age to it.
This chair is just elegance personified. It is beautiful. And I think this is an 18th century one as well.
The wing-back chair first appeared in the early 1700s and quickly became one of the most popular shapes of the 18th century. A chair like this could be worth around £1,500.
Wonderful. £750.
Eight. Thank you.
That's great, thank you.